Today's tutorial is about modding common guns. Found resources, weapon, weapon resource. Click Show in Explorer and drag the resources we want to add into it. Back to Unity. We found that the new gun is here. Then drag the model into the hierarchy panel. We create a shader for it and add related texture. This model has two sets of shaders, so we create another, add texture. Then we drag the shader into the each part on the gun. Open the weapon factory tool and then we observe its shape. There is a grip in the front and then the bolt is on the right, which is very similar to AK5C. So we choose AK5C as a gun template and click AK5C to find that it's replaced in the part of the gun template. If you want to add a new gun, click copy button and you will find that a gun template based on the gun is created under weapon father folder and under FPS guns. If you just want to modify a gun, don't need to click the copy button. The next step is to name all parts of the model we prepared. At this time, we can drag them to observe what they are and then click Ctrl-Z to restore their positions. Then drag it to gun after renaming part and then click import. Then we'll find that it has been imported into the first person and the third person folder. Adjust the position of the two guns. Choose TPS gun, turn it on and then select it. Click scale to resize it. Then click the rotation button to adjust its direction and then click position button to relocate it. Then check if a parameter in weapon ray cast is missing. Then select shot origin to drag it to parent object. Now we can delete the original model. Then we adjust shot origin locator to move it closer to muzzle part. Then we have a third person gun. Check the coordinates of the gun. Adjust it according to the previous standards. Then we can adjust the first person gun. Click FPS gun button. Starting from the size and rotate and then its position. After the adjustment, click Set. The original gun template is gone. This is automatically done by the weapon tool. Also, it helps you to import the named part to related folder. Then we delete the parent object of the new gun. Then we add on a scope and observe the position of attachments. Adjust the scope. Because we have adjusted in-game scopes before, so if one of them meets the standards, then all is automatically adjusted. All we need to do is minor tweaking. After this, let's adjust the silencer of the rifle in the weapon parts. Now we have finished the model adjustment of our first-person gun. Go to the weapon factory again, type in the name of the gun, and click Apply. A new gun called Star is made. Both the FPS and TPS directory has the gun ready to pack. We need to hide first-person guns and the third-person guns by deselecting the little mark on the upper right corner. Also, add the first-person guns to player's weapon list. Drag it to weapon order. Next, run the weapon factory scene to optimize the game experience. Now come to the scene. In the upper middle area, normal mode. Click middle button on the mouse will change it to editor mode. Then find weapon father, find star T in it and turn it on. Now go to training range to make some adjustment. We can see that under the normal mode all available scopes are listed above the window. Left click allows to add one scope. On the right side under inspector zoom Z position means the position of gun while aiming. Then click the red dot scope. We can adjust its position on the inspector panel. After all adjustments, click Apply to save the adjustment. Then holographic scope. If you add a new scope to the gun, remember to select the scope in the weapon table. Click Save again. Then adjust next scope. About the parameters in the zoom base script. Unscale is for scaling. Scale represents the ratio of scaling. And user blur represents whether to use the blur effect around the screen. Then go back to the weapon behavior script to change his performance by adjusting some of the parameters. Sprint, X, Y, and Z position controls. the position while sprint. Now if shoot the gun, it's recoil like this. Then we find the position to adjust the recoil parameters. Set its kick sight and kick roll to 0, which means no recoil. Then increase its view kick and aim recoil to 3. Let's see his recoil performance. At the bottom, all the sound files. Find the shot origin. Adjust it in the scene window. Need to adjust it to the center of the muzzle. After the adjustment, we need to look at the shell eject position and make adjustments. Then we can find the first person gun. Click the apply button at the top right of the inspector panel to finish the adjustment. Use the mod tool to pack the mod. Check icon and gun items, then click set resource name, wait for the process. Then set mod name, description, thumbnail and tag. Then click build mod to start packing. Now we go to the project to find the bundle of packed weapons and icon. Find streaming assets path in the game folder, replace and finally copy the modified item table and weapon table to the game folder. Now let's check it in the game.